magma. This is called basal reinforcement. This is called basal reinforcement. This is called basal reinforcement. Now, see, we are going to use geosynthetics, either it may be geotextile or geogrid, as basal reinforcing layer. Only one layer we use it to keep at the bottom of the embankment in order to construct embankment on soft soil, because in soft soils we can expect base failure when embankment is resting on soft foundation soil. So this is the topic. The first topic is how to analyze the stability of reinforced soil embankment resting on soft foundation. Here I am providing reinforcement only at bottom, only at base, not at any other place. We are providing reinforcement only at base. This is called basal reinforcement. So let us proceed. So what we discussed so far, construction on soft clays. As you know, it's a very challenging task to construct any structure on soft clays, what I say, weak foundation soil, where we use the different techniques to improve the soft soil. What are the different techniques we use to improve the soft soil? This is a very good question. We use some, what we discussed, sand columns, vertical grinds, what I say, preloading, vertical grinds. Sometimes we may use PVDs, prefabricated vertical grinds. As we discussed, geosynthetic encased stone columns. And there are so many techniques available in order to improve the weak foundation soil. So now coming to basal geosynthetic reinforcement is needed to be placed between soft foundation soil and embankment fill to control embankment stability. But it is very important, once base fails, entire structure will fail. Once base fails, that is why it is good to provide a reinforcement at base. So that is the intention of using this word basal reinforcement. So you can use geotextile, you can use geogrid, or if you are looking for better load carrying capacity at base, you may use geosynth. Sometimes we use it to see this. This is an embankment on a soft clay. I can put some geocell layer here. Geocell mattress. So I can put geocell also. Not only geotextile, not only geogrid, I can use geocell. And geocell, bottom of the geocell, you may provide geogrid. So like this, we can enhance the bearing pressure at base of the embankment. So basal reinforcement prevents shear failure, reduces differential settlement. This is very important. And also, in case of basal reinforcement, there is one advantage. Here you see, I am constructing embankment on soft soil. So if you put a load on soft soil, it will consolidate. It will start consolidation. So it will expedite the process of consolidation. So due to embankment loading, this embankment loading is also called preloading. That means without wasting much time for consolidation, we can adopt basal reinforced embankments. So we can able to construct basal reinforced embankment without waiting for much time for consolidation. So that is the advantage of introducing reinforcement at base of the embankment. Here I am using geocell, but most of the time we use it geotextile and geogrid. If you are having a good amount of money, or you are constructing a high embankment, you can provide geocell also at base. This is called basal reinforcement. So now, let us proceed now. So now this is very interesting discussion. What are the different failure modes in an embankment on soft soil? Local failure, bearing capacity failure, global, yesterday we discussed global stability failure, rupture, lateral sliding, pull out, this is what we say anchorage failure. Anchorage. We need to provide proper length of the, which speaks about length of the reinforcement. Yesterday we have discussed about this length. And also the last but not least is foundation extrusions. I will show you what is meant by squeezing out failure, also called foundation extrusions. So there are seven types of failure modes we can expect in case of when embankment is placed on soft or I say soft weak, especially I say soft clay foundation. If your foundation soil is soft clay soil at foundation level, so we can expect these failures. Now I will explain one by one what is local failure, what is bearing capacity failure, what is global, also called overall, and I will try to discuss rupture and lateral sliding, pull out, and foundation extrusions. So there are seven failures modes has been identified by the researchers in the area of those working in the area of embankment on soft foundation soil. One, firstly, so let us discuss local failure of embankment failure. What is meant by local failure? For example, this is the face of the embankment. So this embankment is standing on soft foundation soil. The thing is, there is a small face failure. The failure is happened locally, only locally. If there is no global failure, you don't think that the entire slope is failed. Only a small portion of slope is failed. Small portion of slope failed. Small portion of slope failed. Then it is called local slope failure. I will repeat once again. A small portion of slope failed. Let me say, for example, it is a sandy soil. Let me say C0. So what will be the formula for factor of safety? We all know tan phi by tan beta. Now what is beta? Slope angle. Angle of slope. What is phi? Friction of the sand. Angle of internal friction of the fill material, sand. For example, I have considered two horizontal, one vertical slope. That means 26.6 degrees angle of slope, phi 30 degrees. Let me say a conventional sand, natural sand. Okay, what could be the factor of safety? Here you see, I'm getting tan 30 by tan 26, it is almost greater than 1. So, and that means I cannot expect any local failure. Okay, there is no local failure. Now coming to bearing capacity failure. This is very interesting. Let us all discuss now. So this is an embankment. Resting on a soft foundation soil. So everyone knows that what will happen if a foundation resting on a soil, what are different failure zones? Can anyone say now? Now this is zone 1, zone 2, zone 3. And similarly, if an embankment foundation soil, what are the expected failure zones in the foundation soil? So here you can see a triangular variation. This is called elastic zone. This is radial shear zone. This is Rankine's passive zone. In the same way. Now coming to how to calculate ultimate bearing capacity. We all know how to calculate ultimate bearing capacity when putting in rests on a weak soft clay. So we all know CNC. So the weight coming from the embankment is gamma into H. So now this CNC should be more than gamma fill into height of fill. Otherwise, what will happen? This embankment is punched into the foundation soil. So this is our interest is to find whether this foundation soil is safe against bearing capacity or not. That means it should have enough bearing capacity. So CNC should be more than gamma H. CNC should be more than gamma H, gamma fill material into height of the fill material. So sometimes I call fill, or sometimes we call embankment. Both are same. Embankment and fill, both are same. Now you see, NC, generally we take 5.7. Generally we take 5.7. Now let us see, Q allowable is equal to Q ultimate by factor of safety. Now this is about bearing capacity failure. Next, coming to global stability, also called overall stability. See, this is all everyone knows how to calculate a factor of safety for the entire slope. For the entire slope, especially it is a total slope failure. You can expect failure plane not only within the embankment, also there in foundation soil. It is not local failure. It is not just within the embankment. The failure plane is there from top of the embankment to base of the embankment. So that means we have considered full-fledged failure surface. So how to calculate factor of safety in this case? We all know how to calculate factor of safety. So just let us see now, factor of safety is equal to, you might be known how to calculate factor of safety is equal to sum of resisting moments by sum of overturning moments. So here see, what is resisting moment? So we all know, here you see, this is CE. E stands for embankment. F stands for foundation soil. Now the, somebody can ask me how to calculate resistance in this zone. I can write now, resisting shear is Cu into length of the arc within the embankment into, this is the entire shearing resistance offered within the embankment zone. Now coming to what is the shearing resistance we are having when it comes to failure plane within the foundation. Now C, I know F into what is this length of the arc within the embankment. So now I want moment. How to calculate moment with respect to center of rotation? Force into lever arm. Here lever arm means radius of the failure surface. So we used to discuss in several occasions about how to calculate factor of safety, especially in slope stability analysis. Now somebody can ask me, oh, why you are writing WEXE, WFXF? So you think and tell me. So why I'm writing WEXE, WX? Because I'm considering global stability. Let me tell you once again. I'm considering global stability. Global stability means we use it to consider failure of the slope right from top level of the embankment to base of the embankment. Even if we try to consider failure plane below the embankment, that is foundation soil, because we can expect base failure in case of an embankment is resting on weak soil. So now here you see W into XE, WF into XF. So no need to bother about this. W into XE is the weight of the sliding wedge within the embankment, this one. So I think in the last semester in computer lab, we have done all these things. Now coming to this, you see, I want WF, weight of the sliding wedge within the foundation soil. So this is the sliding wedge portion within the foundation soil. Now how to calculate XF from center of rotation, XF from center of rotation, XE. So now sum of resisting moment by sum of overturning moment. If you provide basal reinforcement, if you provide basal reinforcement, what is going to be happen to factor of safety? Sum of resisting moment by sum of overturning moment. So now overturning is also called driving moment. Now somebody can ask me, sir, how to calculate if basal reinforcement is there, how to calculate factor of safety? It's a good question. So CELE, CFLF into R, because moment is force into lever arm. Now T into Y. What is T? Tensile strength of the basal reinforcement. Let me show you now. See, this is the tensile strength of the basal reinforcement. Now this is the vertical distance from center of rotation to position of reinforcement. Y is vertical distance. That what I say from center of rotation to position of reinforcement. Here the position of reinforcement is horizontal. I kept one layer of reinforcement at base only. Let me tell you, this is basal reinforcement. Basal means it's not as long as base. Place at base, basal reinforcement. Now, let us discuss now. So T into Y. So this T into Y, if you provide reinforcement, I'm getting extra plus into T into Y. So this will improve the factor of safety. This will improve the factor of safety. That is why it is advisable to provide the basal reinforcement, especially when you are trying to construct highway embankment or railway embankment or any embankment on weak foundation soil. So, and also it is very easy to provide. So we can reduce a lot of time for consolidation. So we don't worry about any vertical drains and all. So we just provide one basal reinforcement, then we will start construction of embankment. So that's why we don't worry about anything, just we will provide reinforcement at base. This additional resisting moment is getting from T into Y. T, what is T? Somebody can ask me. T is nothing but required tensile strength of the geotextile or geogrid or geocell. I say simply geosynthetic. So let us proceed. Now see, if you are having a soil, either it's maybe a embankment soil or foundation soil, is C5 soil. If C5 soil is there, you cannot use ordinary method, what I say, Swedish method. So we should use method of slices. How to adopt method of slices? Take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 equal width, you know all the method. Then how to calculate factor safety? C into length of the arc, you know length of the arc. How to calculate length of the arc? These things we have discussed. Pi r theta by 180. So this is theta. So anyhow, so you know, here two components, if you resolve the slice in two components, it is alpha, this one is alpha, you know, you can resolve into W cos alpha, W sin alpha. If pore water depth pressure is there, if water table is there, we should deduct minus UI into LI. Now total movement, I want R. Now plus, if reinforcement is provided, basal reinforcement is provided. Plus T into Y. So now coming to this is, you know that tangential component of the slices. So sigma, why I'm writing sigma? Because number of slices are there. So W1 sin alpha 1, W2 sin alpha 2, like that, into R, because I want movement. So once again, I tell sum of resisting moment by sum of overturning. So from this, I can get factor of safety if you are dealing with C5 soil. So if you are not comfortable with C5 soil, you don't write about this. You don't worry, you write just only, some student may ask, so you are telling only 5-0 analysis. This is 5-0 analysis. That means untried condition. I told you, your soil is saturated. Frankly speaking, undrained condition. If it is a drained condition, you should not use this. You should not neglect 5. We have to consider 5 in picture. How to consider then in C5 soil, because C is there, 5 is there. Soil is having C and 5. In case of cohesive frictional soil, you have to do method of slices. Otherwise, you can take a single failure surface, a single arc, so that we can manage just by applying C into a single length of arc into R. So we are getting resisting moment. Now, so far what we discussed, so about local failure, just now we discussed global failure. Global means overall failure. We have seen overall failure. It's not just limited to face, it's limited from top to not only bottom, even beyond bottom, and also bearing capacity fail. Now let me show you rupture fail. Here rupture means, you see, I am providing basal reinforcement. I am providing basal reinforcement, geosynthetic basal reinforcement. So what will happen, reinforcement fails in tension. This reinforcement, sometimes the rupture will occur and embankment slides to our foundation soil. See, this embankment is trying to slide. This kind of failure is called rupture. This kind of failure is called rupture. This could happen in case of whenever you are provided basal reinforcement. So now, let us see now, I don't want to teach too much mathematics, but here you see, this is the force coming from fill. So this is the weight of the sliding slope, weight of the sliding slope. This is the length of the sliding slope. This is the height of the embankment. Now somebody can ask me how to calculate driving force, P fill, of Ka gamma H square, you know, active force. Now the thing is, shear force at the bottom of the embankment. We all know shear force, everyone knows S is equal to C plus sigma tan phi. So I want force over the length into Ls, Ca into Ls. Now the thing is, how to calculate factor of safety against rupture, total resisting force by total driving force. This is driving force. It should not less than 1.5. Now the thing is, I am getting factor of safety against rupture, Tg, required tensile strength of geogrid, required tensile strength of geogrid, geogrid or geotextile. Now plus Ca into Ls by driving force. 0.5, sometimes we use it to observe 0.5. 0.5 means 1 by 2. Ka gamma E H square by 2. So it should not less than 1.5. We need to check. See, somebody can ask me, sir, I had a problem. So after doing this calculation, I'm not getting 1.5. So what we will do now? You please respond. I'm not getting 1.5. So I will see in chart box. Now, if I am not getting factor of safety, I will write in chart box, factor of safety against rupture, against, I need to check spelling also, I think, against rupture is less than 1.5. What I have to do? What I have to do? What you will suggest? What I have to do? I'm telling about basal reinforcement. Please respond. You please over your mind, because yesterday you have given wonderful answers. No doubt. So if you are getting factor of safety against rupture, that means your embankment is in trouble now. Your embankment is going to be failed. Even you provide basal reinforcement. It is not just keeping some reinforcement. Somebody say that I have kept basal reinforcement at bottom, but still embankment is failed. What is the reason? So why it was failed? Because it may be, the reason may be rupture. So the reason may be rupture. Now, how to improve the factor of safety against rupture? Can anyone suggest me now? What I have to do now? Please tell me. So what you will suggest now in order to improve the factor of safety against rupture? So there is one option is very important. Option is, one is very important is decreasing the height of the embankment. Decreasing the height of the embankment. It may not be possible. Or using lightweight fill like geofoam, some other material. So lightweight fills. And one more point, using high strength geogrid, high stiffness geogrid. Let me tell you once again. High strength geogrid. It's not just using a 10 kilonewton per meter. You have to use 30 kilonewton per meter, sometimes 50 kilonewton per meter. So if you improve the tensile strength of the geosynthetic, you will have a better factor of safety against rupture. So it is not just keeping the reinforcement at base. We have to provide reinforcement which has enough required tensile strength. Please listen carefully. So that's why we have to increase the tensile strength. So such type of geogrid you need to procure from the market. So that geogrid you should use in design. That geogrid you should use in design as well as in construction. So that is the thing we have to realize here. So let us proceed now. After rupture, you see, just now we discussed. So there is a lateral, we have discussed rupture is there. Rupture. So this particular geosynthetic is in kink. Kink, what I say, the right language, there is some rupture. Kink. So in order to control the, see, once if this rupture is propagating, ultimately what will happen, after crack, the entire portion of the embankment will slide. So this is called lateral sliding. So if you want to reduce lateral sliding, we have to provide higher strength, not only strength, stiffness, geo grid. So somebody can ask me, what is the required Young's modulus of the geo grid? In design, we should select the stiffness of the geo grid. E means, if I'm mistaken, here I will write E means stiffness. If you are not comfortable with the stiffness, I will write Young's modulus. If you are not comfortable with Young's modulus, I will write elastic modulus. So while you are selecting geo grid or geo textile, that geo textile should have Young's modulus 10 times Tmax. So maximum tensile force I can able to calculate by gamma h tan phi b by 2. So the thing is, while you're providing geosynthetic at base, we need to take care about its tensile strength and its stiffness. So stiffness should be, required stiffness should be 10 times maximum tensile stress. So this is what I would like to share with you. Now, a very important failure, that is pull-off. Yesterday we have discussed about pull-off, how to calculate pull-off. Yes, see, this pull-off. So if you have not provided sufficient reinforcement at base, sufficient length, sometimes you want to reduce the money, you want to reduce the cost, so we have provided reinforcement up to this length only. Or sometimes you have provided reinforcement up to small length at base, no use. You have to calculate length required based on pull-on. As you know, two times, yesterday we have discussed CA, sigma V, tan delta L. TH, actually stress in geosynthetic. Now L required is equal to TH by 2E CA sigma. Here I am using E. E means, somebody can ask me what is E. E means anchorage pull-out efficiency. Generally, if it is a geotextile, it has less anchorage. Whereas geogrid is having higher anchorage efficiency. Higher 1.2. That's why we generally recommend geogrid. Because of higher strength, higher stiffness, and higher anchorage efficiency. So now, last but not least, foundation extrusions. See, foundation extrusion, that also called squeezing out failure. If the foundation soil is very soft, that's what we are discussing, beneath the embankment, to a limiting depth up to less than width of the slope, soil may squeeze out due to outward shear stress as shown in figure. I will show you. See, this foundation soil is trying to, this some block is trying to move away. Once this stress is acting from embankment, what we can expect? We can expect sliding of soil. This is what is a lateral extrusion of foundation soil. This we can understand, we can observe. So this analysis, one can see now. So factor safety against squeezing, it may not be required, but I can easily explain here. Resisting is from passive resistance. This is passive resistance. And TT, TB. That means what I say, I have a shear force at top, I have shear force at bottom. So these are two forces are resisting the sliding. Now the driving force is always active force. So anyhow, This is maybe too much mathematics for us. It should be greater than 1.3. So this is about the topic called foundation on weak soils, embankment on weak soils. So we have two topics for discussion today. One is stability analysis of reinforced soil embankment. Another one is stability analysis of reinforced soil slopes. So these two topics we need to discuss in this class. So I will repeat once again without wasting time what we discussed so far. We know that we are going to construct embankments, highway embankment, road gani, railway track gani, vesinappudu embankment kattam okokka sari embankment anedi soft soil meda kattal chustu. If the soil is soft, it may be a marine clay or it may be a regular loose clay, okay, soft clay. So in that situation we can expect base failure. So that means we can expect the entire foundation may sink, foundation soil may sink. So excessive settlement we can see. So in order to prevent excessive settlement, especially differential settlement, I am keeping a layer of geosynthetic. Even layer of geosynthetic, let me tell you, layer of geosynthetic will balance differential settlement. So if the differential settlement can be controlled by providing geosynthetic layer at the base of the embankment. So provision of embankment at base of the embankment is called basal reinforcement. We are keeping reinforcement at the base of the embankment. That's why it is called basal reinforcement. It's not a something new word. So basal reinforcement on soft clay is one solution. So which can easily contract base failure. But as an engineer, our job is to decide the length of the reinforcement and also required tensile strength of the reinforcement. So this is the job of the engineer. It is not just understanding, keeping the is not enough. Understanding basal reinforcement is not enough. We have to design the basal reinforcement. Now coming to what are different types of failures: local failure, bearing capacity failure, global failure. Everyone knows this overall slope failure. So you please do only 5-0 analysis. It is comfortable to you. If you are having good knowledge, you can work on C5 analysis. C5 analysis is meant for cohesive soil. 5-0 analysis is for pure clays, pure cohesive soils, where 5 is 0. Now next, rupture, also called tearing. Next, lateral siding, pull out failure, squeezing out failure. So once rupture started, sliding will happen. To control rupture sliding, we need to provide proper anchorage, proper length of the reinforcement. I will repeat once again. In order to avoid rupture and subsequent lateral sliding, we need to provide proper length of the reinforcement. And also we need to provide proper stiffness of the reinforcement. So we have to design the reinforcement in such a way that its stiffness is equal to 10 times T maximum. So this is about potential failure modes in an embankment on soft foundation. So I will conclude now. So I will just tell you. So now how to work out about the second topic. This is also very interesting, and also everyone knows this topic also. We are all very familiar with this topic: stability analysis of reinforced soil slopes. So far, what we discussed is stability analysis of embankment on soft clay. Now we are exactly entering into the topic. Now let me tell you, we are providing reinforcement not only at base. I am providing reinforcement within the embankment also. That is reinforced embankment. Let me tell you once again why it is called, it is a reinforced slope. Within my slope, within this slope, within this slope reinforcement is introduced. Reinforcement is introduced. I'm getting messages, let me check. Okay, now let us see. Now I am providing reinforcement within the slope. Please understand, not only at base. So far we discussed basal reinforcement. For example, one reinforcement layer, its tensile strength t1, t2, t3 up to tm. Here I can expect m number of layers. Now let us see. Now this, just I am using limiting equilibrium design. Limiting equilibrium, everyone knows it. So how to calculate factor of safety? So you know that factor of safety is equal to sum of resisting moment by sum of overturning moment. So you know, if it is C5 analysis, you may not be happy to see C5 analysis. I know, but see, you should add sigma T I Y A. Sigma T I. Somebody can ask me why I am writing T I Y A. I want to M. M is, can anyone say M is number of geosynthetic layers. So now let us see. Now if you are not happy, I will use undrained condition, that is saturated soil. So I am trying to say CCU 50. So then I can write simply now CUL length of the arc R plus sigma T I by I by WX. This is very easy method, just simple method. So if you are not able to write CFA analysis, at least you write about undrained condition. So we all know that CU into length of the arc is the resisting shear along the failure surface multiplying with R. R is Lebrun, where R is radius of failure surface, radius of arc. Okay, now sum of resisting moment by sum of volume. This is the formula we are using. Now, before we are concluding the class, we will try to solve one problem. Okay, so all of you please get ready for solving this problem. So this problem gives maximum knowledge to you. I can assure you this small problem will give a lot of concept to you. Okay, so now when it comes to examination, so we cannot able to calculate resisting moment and driving moment. So because it's a very complicated process, we need computer. You might be seen in last semester how to find the weight of the sliding wedge. This is a very cumbersome task. It's not easy. We need a graph sheet. We need a minimum 4 to 5 hours to solve this problem. That's why in questions they use it to do resisting moment. It is given in question. Resisting moment is given, driving moment is given. Now the thing is, he is asking us to calculate factor of safety without reinforcement, with reinforcement. Factor of safety without reinforcement. Now how to calculate factor of safety? Sum of resisting moment by sum of overturning. Luckily, he has given in question 2010 kilonewton meter per meter resisting moment. Driving moment is also given. Now our job is just dividing 2010 by 2570. I'm getting 0.78. It clearly indicates the slope is instable. It clearly indicates failure occurs. Now, how to reduce the failure? Please tell me. It is your choice now. How to reduce failure? That means I will introduce reinforcement. I will introduce reinforcement. So I will provide reinforcement now in layers like this, beyond failure plane. This is failure plane. You know that in rotational failure, the failure surface is assumed as arc. So I want to provide the reinforcement beyond failure surface. Now, you please tell me now how to calculate factor of safety. So I have T1, T2, T3, T4 like that. The number of the center of rotation, I can able to calculate Y1, Y2. So if some case, they may give Y average. In order to reduce the calculation time, he has given Y average here, 14.3. Now, how to calculate factor of safety? Factor of safety, I have taken 1.4. So, I am taking factor of safety in my hand. So, now the question is 2010, same resisting moment plus M. What is M? Number of layers. Number of layers. Now M. So what is T allowable? T allowable is also given. I have selected a geo grid which has tensile strength 6.67. Now what I am getting? Number of geo grid layers is 16.6. There will not be 16.6. Here we cannot expect answer in decimals, because number of layers may be, it should be rounded number. It's never be 16.6, it's never be 16.1, 16.9 also. It may be 17, it may be 16. So now how many layers I have to provide now? 17 layers I have to provide. 17 layers I have to provide. If I provided 17 layers, I can ensure factor of safety 1.4. So this is design. What is meant by design? Here the design means how many number of layers I have to keep. Once again, I will tell you. Here design means how many number of layers I have to introduce in the embankment. The topic is reinforced embankment. But it is not just basal reinforcement. Even the reinforcement is there in the embankment also. So how many number of layers? This can be done by just general method of slope stability analysis, limiting equilibrium method, by using formula sum of resisting moment by sum of resisting. Once you are introducing reinforcement, you have to add M into T allowable into Y average. Actually, somebody can ask me, why you are not writing T1, Y1, T2, Y2. So it is a very tedious process. The questioner has simplified, he has given Y average. The vertical centroidal distance, he has given average centroidal distance 14.3 in question. This is given in question. Now how to calculate number of geogrid layers? So please, all of you, have a look on this. I need 17 layers in order to achieve the desired factor of safety 1.4. Usually we concentrate 1.3. So here he has taken a much care. We are trying to take factor of safety 1.3. So design means, once again I tell you, how many number of layers to be placed to achieve the desired factor of safety. Once factor of safety more than 1, or I say more than 1.3, the slope is stable. Otherwise, see, in the last case, in the case one, it was failed. It was failed because it is less than, even it is less than 1.3. Even it is less than 1. You just imagine the dangerous condition of the embankment. Now this embankment is stable by introducing layer of geogrids. I will use the symbol for geogrid by introducing how many layers? So let me ask, how many layers? Please tell me now. How many layers we need to introduce? 17. So with this, I'm concluding this class. Before I am concluding, I request you people, please have a look on your geosynthetics class. Please, all of you, I'm concluding my class. Now you don't worry about the lecture. Please see above document. Since morning I am preparing for a class, so I have prepared all the material for your sake. I will send this material to you. You don't worry. I'm not testing your patience. I will send all the material. Just you give me 15 to 20 minutes. I will scan all the matter. I will send to you. This is the synopsis of our all discussions in this unit. Nothing is skipped. All the information is there. You don't worry. Now let us think about how to answer this home assignment. Now, because I have selected a good questions as a part of home assignment. You don't mistaken. This home assignment is very useful to you. Okay. So even useful for examinations, even for learning subject. So I have prepared a very good number of questions for the benefit of all, for exams, for understanding. So now I am opening home assignment 4. You also please open. Now the lecture is completed. Now let me hear from you. So function, print screen. Even I'm for 3:15 I started my lecture. Maybe 4:15 I completed, but I have done a lot of homework. I will do homework. I don't want to play with you people. So now let us see now. Again, I am testing you. You are not reaching that. Okay. Function, print screen. Yes. So, hope you can see now. Yes, please see now from assignment one. I think it is visible to you. What are the potential failure modes in embankment on soft foundation soil? I will repeat once again. What are the potential failure modes in an embankment on soft foundation soil? If you are not good enough to understand, you write bearing capacity failure, overall slope stability. Even if you are not able to spell that word, overall or global, you write stability, slope stability failure, bearing capacity failure. We all know pullout failure, rupture failure, or you can also write squeezing out failure. So around seven types of failures has been discussed. Seven types of, I will type in WhatsApp because some people are missing the class. Maybe we want to reach them also. We don't have any problem with anyone. My intention is my lecture should reach to each and every student. I don't have any problem. My interest is that only. I'm not targeting anyone. My job is to deliver the thing at the best. Deliver the lecture at the best. Okay, now you please answer it in WhatsApp so that others will realize the how we are utilizing this 1 hour. So please don't hesitate to answer this question. So if you answer this question, you please take snap. The same thing you can upload in Moodle also in home assignment. Now let us all work together. You write the names, that is enough for me. Please, all of you, write names of different failure modes in embankment rests on. I'm slow in typing this way. Just on weak soil, weak, I say soft, it's good to write soft, foundation soil. Foundation soil means soil below the embankment. Embankment means you just understand it is road. Simply, embankment means road, a railway track. Okay, so now you please try to answer now. So whatever you are writing, I will wait for 5 minutes, please. It's just 4:17. We logged in 3:15. It is just 4:15. Within 2 minutes, I will wind up. Don't worry. So let me see now answers from you people. I hope you will answer. I'm very happy to hear from you. So please write on paper. Better you write on paper, and please post in the WhatsApp group. The people missing the class, they will also get benefit. That is my intention. There is no bad intention. Okay, so let us all work now. So who will post first, he will get maximum marks. So we always lure the students with marks. There is no other option. So please tell me now. Can anyone say now? So you just write the names, that is enough for me. So I will show you, even if you are finding difficulty, I will show you. Don't worry. I will show you. I will help you also. Yes. Just see now. Yes. One is local failure. A failure of the embankment happen only at top or limited extent only. The failure is not happened from entire slope or not happen right from embankment to foundation. So the failure is only localized. Let me write where failure is. It's a very good language. Where failure is localized. That means a small failure, like face failure. Let me show you face failure. Small failure. slip, small slip happen, localized, just bearing capacity failure, global stability, rupture, lateral sliding, pull out. Next, last one is very interesting, squeezing out. The foundation soil will also move. Foundation soil also shears. So this is called what I say, foundation extrusion, also called squeezing out failure. So let us expect answers, I think. Or else, okay, if you answer this one, we will discuss next question also. That is why I am waiting for you. So it's a matter of 2 minutes, write these names. So I will do one thing. So for the benefit of all, you also please write function. Maybe you may not be ready, but I will help you in another way. 1 second. Okay. This is my answer. You can see my answer. So I will write here. Answer to the first question. Answer to first question. Home assignment. Yes, see this magna. Atla raskunda undante manaku konni vishayalu telustayi. Home assignment 4, I think. Yes. Okay. So you also can take your own time. Okay. Because I don't want to trouble you people. Anyhow. So like this, I must reply here. It's good to reply. We should encourage the students. Reply. It's good. Anyhow, it's good. Charan is also written. It's good. I think people will realize we are not playing. My interest is, yes, people are working. We are not working. They will realize. They feel that they are experts, but they realize at the one point of time, everybody will realize in our life. Yes, Mr. Sandeep, beautifully written. Beautifully, simply, simply so. Like that. You please scan this, scan whatever you have written and submit as home assignment. Don't spend much time. You write your name and number on top of the paper and please scan this and submit as home assignment. You don't worry. So you will get a lot of time saving now. Simply super. Well, let us discuss next question. So I think in meeting I have still yes, good number of students are there. Okay, no problem. So rest, I think we will solve this last problem. So let me take this problem now. I am ready. Okay. So I am discussing about this question. If you are ready. Yes, function print screen. I hope you will answer this question within 2 minutes. Yes. Please answer second question now. I hope it is visible. Please answer second question. Of home assignment. If you answer, you can save time. No need to spend time once again with the assignment. Control C. If it is not visible, I can understand. I know the problems faced by the students. So I will send you. Don't worry. Yes. Is it okay now? Yes. Now I just send the text also. Don't worry. Now, what I am expecting from you students, I want to hear from you how many number of layers required. That's what only I am expecting. How many number of layers required. So please work out. I will show you the answer. You don't worry. How to answer, I will help you because I know. You know the situation now. Fortunately, we are having this webcam facility. I'm using this. Yes. So please tell me now, first part of the problem, how to calculate factor of safety without reinforcement. Factor of safety. People are disturbing me. Factor of safety without reinforcement. factor of safety. So sorry, whenever I am getting phone, the problem, I am connecting my phone only. That's why I am looking for new phone. I think I need one more phone or one webcam. Okay, no problem. So tell me now, what is the factor of safety? Anyone ready to answer, please? మీరు చెప్తారు ఇప్పుడు చూడండి, వీళ్ళు వర్క్ చేస్తున్నారు అంటే ఏం లేదు, మనం వర్క్ చేస్తాయండి మన మీద మనకి. ఎస్ 0.78. ప్లీజ్ షేర్ మీ ద ఆన్సర్ ఆల్సో, ఇట్స్ గుడ్ ఐ థింక్, సో దట్ పీపుల్ విల్ అండర్స్టాండ్, దే విల్ ఆల్సో వర్క్. ప్లీజ్ షేర్ యువర్ ఆన్సర్ షీట్. మన పని మనం చేసుకోవాలి, వీ నీడ్ టు డూ అవర్ జాబ్. ఐ విల్ షేర్ మై ఆన్సర్. ఐ థింక్ సేమ్ క్వశ్చన్, ఐ థింక్ 2010 సేమ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్, 2010 2570. ఎస్ సేమ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్. ఎస్ ఐ డోంట్ వాంట్ రిస్క్ ఎనీ వన్స్ లైఫ్ నా. ఇప్పుడు నేనేం ప్రయోగాలు చేయట్లేదు, ఐ నాట్ డూయింగ్ ఎనీ. ఎస్ ఎస్ ఎస్, this is the answer. Within seconds we got the answer. Very good. Even I will also send my answer. Yes, now, yes, this is my answer. Now if you provide reinforcement, how many number of reinforcing layers required if factor of safety expected is 1.4? Factor of safety expected is 1.4. How many number of layers are to be? T is given, tensile strength of the geogrid. Already you are an academic student, you have conducted some tensile strength test, you got the tensile strength, you have applied all reduction factors and you are taking further care. Now you see here, T allowable is equal to 6.67. now we are getting whatever your T allowable, I am substituting here 6.67. now M, I don't know. 14.3 is given in question. So I will show you. 14.3 is given. If anything is missing, you please tell me. Yes, 14.3 is given. Average centroidal reinforcement. So it's your time now. Take your own time. I'm not making you hurry. I'm just thinking about you people only. So please tell me. Please share your answer. Any difficulty is there, you please unmute and speak with me. Or you can call me, you can chat with me. So I made this concept very simple now. So in this time, I know the present situation. Still, we want to work together. That is the very interesting thing. Still, we are trying to learn something. We are not trying to comment one each other. Now, even in this situation, we are utilizing the time. We are understanding the beautiful concepts of reinforced soil structures. Yesterday we have spoken about reinforced soil walls. Today we are speaking about reinforced soil slopes, nothing but embankments. Reinforced soil embankments. Just with basic knowledge of geotechnical engineering, we are trying to understand geosynthetics and how to design with geosynthetics. Just by knowing basic rudiments of geotechnical engineering. So it's your time now. So 1.4 already given in question. Why average is already given kitchen, MR is given, MD is given. So we need to calculate small m, and also we have to calculate T allowable. T allowable is equal to T ultimate by pi RF. What is pi RF? I will write here. Pi RF means, you might be remembered our early days of discussions, where we discussed pi RF is cumulative reduction factors. Please tell me now, what is your answer? So please share your answer sheet, I think, so that I can conclude the lecture. Yes, so 16.7 is on an odd figure. There should not be 16.6 layers, 17 layers. Charan has got the answer. So I think I should appreciate all. Thank you all. Thank you all. So I will complete this answer also, because people think that I am not working. No, actually, I have worked. I am not working is not correct. Since morning, I am working. Since last 6 hours, I am working. That's why I am late to class. I am late to class because I am preparing class. Because I am preparing class, I want to simplify the format. I want to simplify the format. So that's why I am late. Okay. Let me take a screenshot. Now I can present in WhatsApp now. Yes, I got the answer. Yes, you are correct. Number of, I will write now. Thank you all. Any questions you can ask me. Otherwise, you can sign out. I don't have any problem with you. Number of layers, 17. Thank you. Thank you once again. Thank you all. Once again. Tomorrow, I will try to finish the next topic, foundations on foundations on reinforced soil beds. Okay, so with this, I'm concluding today's class. Thank you all once again. If anything you want to ask, you can ask me. I will be stay there. No problem. At least we are working in this situation. You know the current situation. So thanks for understanding. Thanks for understanding. We are not playing with time, we are understanding time. Thanks for understanding. I will send the class link also today. So I have recorded the entire session also.